way I see it, it was a military coup that occurred yesterday or last night in Egypt. Today, the military is fully in control rather than any the parliament or anybody else. And right now, the face of this military coup is Omar Suleiman. The question is, how long will he last in that role?
Tell me about Omar Suleiman. You have good knowledge of him. You've been on the ground many times in Egypt, and you know the region well. What kind of man is he? Is he a military figure? Is he now in charge of the military?
He's a former general, and he took over Egyptian intelligence. And at that point, he started to take control of the military. He certainly has all the files on the military and knows what's going on. But there's still a certain amount of resentment among several generals in particular who may remove him at some point.
So this may just be the beginning of further turmoil in Egypt.
I think absolutely. The head of the artillery and the head of the infantry, who are very, very powerful and believe that the military should have a lasting role in Egyptian politics.
Tell me, with all your knowledge of that area, do you agree with that? Do you think that it may be the best thing for Egypt that they do have military control? Because what we've been seeing in the last 10 days is a very well-disciplined military who have not got violent, and you know, there is an argument that they may do a better job than the politicians.
Oh, I think absolutely they will for the time being. There's no organized political opposition in Egypt that can take over now, certainly not the Muslim Brotherhood, which is fragmented. And the other parties, the WAF, they just cannot do it themselves. And I don't, without the military, I think almost definitely there would be chaos in Egypt for the long term.
If you were still a CIA operative, what do you think the top brass at the CIA would be most concerned about from what they're witnessing tonight?
I think what they should be concerned about is the army holds together. I'd see no reason that it shouldn't. But anything that would push Egypt to a civil war should concern the CIA.
And in terms of the peace process, in particular the peace treaty between Israel and Egypt, but also on a wider level between Israel and Palestine, for example, how could this be adversely affected by events over the next few months?
Well, I mean, this is very much a nationalistic coup d'etat, and the accords with Israel, the peace treaty, isn't particularly popular. So I would be worried about the military throwing red meat to the street and the Egyptians, for instance, giving more support to Hamas, opening up the border into Gaza, for instance, a turn against the PLO. But right now, the only thing the military is concerned about is consolidating power, and we're not going to know for several weeks in which way they're going to go.
We've already seen scenes this evening of Hamas on the West Bank celebrating what they're witnessing in Egypt. They're not doing it because they're pleased to see democracy thriving. They're doing it because they're seeing people power overthrowing a regime they don't like, aren't they?
It's a good example for them, because then what they're saying is, look, we can overthrow the PLO, Mahmoud Abbas, as well. Why not? Let's take the West Bank. And while we're at it, let's move over to Jordan. I mean, we're opening the floodgates in the Middle East, that these autocrats are removable and they can easily be removed without a civil war. And this will, echo through the Middle East for a long time.
Bob Baer, thank you very much.
Thank you.